captain of the USA team. We're here in Tallinn, Estonia.
Hi, I'm Kyle Lewis. I'm from Seattle, Washington, United States of America. I drive on the USA team, boat number 93, the Left Coast Ghost.
My name is Mike Ackerstrom. I'm from Westford, Mass. I'm a driver for the USA team, and I run the number 8 Ironhead in the OSY 400 class.
Hello, my name is Rachel Warnock. I'm the executive administrator for the USA team, 7 years on the team. So now let's race the boats.
Arriving in Tallinn on Wednesday afternoon was the 2016 USA team crew, consisting of Billy and Racer Allen, Rachel Warnock, Kyle Lewis, Mike and Alan Ackerstrom, Lois and Dudley Smith, and photographer Dave Recht. While the young drivers explored Tallinn, Billy and Racer received word that their boat shipment was delayed. They holed up in their hotel room trying to sort it out, Rachel sending rapid-fire messages to the shipping agents and Billy trying not to puke.
So as a driver, I think what most distinguishes me is that I'm new to the international circuit. No one knows what to expect, no one knows how I drive except for my teammates. So I think that might give me a little bit of an advantage.
To be representing the U.S. during Olympic year is absolutely incredible. Our event is recognized by the International Olympic Committee, and so I guess we're kind of the tip of the spear, if you will, for the American Olympic team. It's an honor, it's a lot of pressure, it's a little bit terrifying. It's really amazing to be representing America this year.
It was a long night of emails and texts and phone calls trying to get this thing out of customs, so we finally got cleared. It's a huge relief to me and our team. And now we will go unpack the container and bring it down to the pits.
Okay, cool. We'll meet you guys down there around 11.
The goal is to not hit anything, right? Yeah,
exactly. Oh my god, such a relief to get the boats out of customs.
So we just got a call from our customs clearance agent who said that the carnet was not complete and stamped by U.S. Customs. So what they're telling me now is that our container now sits in one of these custom houses over here, but the Estonian Customs can't release it. So now the value of our everything in our container is about $25,000. So we have to come up with a $25,000 deposit. So right now we're trying to contact our shipper in the U.S. and see if we can get the paperwork squared away and over here. But it is now Friday at noontime, and the race is tomorrow. So the clock's ticking on us now. And we have all these people waiting here to get the boats. And we're just kind of running on hope here that we can get this thing squared away. The race director, Algo Cuss, over here working the phone for us and doing his absolute best to get this thing cleared out of customs. So we'll just have to wait and hope. So that's where we stand right now, Friday at noontime.
While Billy waited in anticipation, the team headed down to the pits to check out the competition.
So here we are in beautiful Tallinn, Estonia at the race site. There at the World Championships in Europe, we run 4 heats, but only the best 3 are scored. Based on your finish in Heat 1, that determines your starting point on the jetty in Heat 2. If you don't finish a heat, or you fall out of the boat, or whatever, you get sent down all the way to the end.
So this is my first World Championships, and witnessing it for the first time is extremely exciting. It's really cool. There are 20 teams maybe, and they're all speaking different languages. And I've had a chance to meet a couple of the competitors, and I gotta say, they're really nice so far, but we'll see if that carries over on the water.
Race director Algo Kuss worked tirelessly, and the Estonian Racing Federation fronted the $25,000 deposit.
We made it, as Kyle said.
We're here.
As the van pulled in Friday night, a round of applause went up in the UIM meeting close by. The plight of the American shipping woes had circulated through the pits, and everyone was relieved to see their red, white, and blue hydros.
Estonia rocks.
And we have boats. And hopefully tonight we're going to get our technical inspection done, all of our scrutineering, and get cleared to race tomorrow. So, I just got mostly scrutineered. You know, we passed pretty easily. You know, our boats are up to code.
Now, the team had the opportunity to reunite with their international friends and competitors before heading down to get weighed.
So we're here in Tallinn, Estonia on Friday night, and as you can see, our pits are now quiet. And everybody's gone up for dinner, and we just finished with setting everything up, scrutineering, we got registered, and everybody double-checked their setups. We had a little bit of mechanical work to do, and luckily, the sun shines light here in Estonia in the summertime, so it's almost 9 o'clock now, it's still light out, and we got everything done that we needed to do, so tomorrow, we'll be ready to race.
See you going in that first turn.
Dude, I bet.
Four.
You think so?
Oh yeah, you'll qualify good.
I don't know, man.
The first day of racing dawned clear and sunny on the USA team as they attended the international competition's first driver's meeting.
So far I've noticed that everyone is really serious. The driver's meeting was run by a guy named Vorha.
We have here today for the virtual.
And he was extremely succinct and to the point, and I really appreciated that. And it's a lot of fun, everyone seems to be smiling.
I have a...
So the scale of racing internationally is off the charts. This is a huge event.
Race coordinator Varhu Juala welcomed 60 drivers from 14 countries and two continents.
So today's the big day. We have time trials in about 45 minutes, practice in about 45 minutes, then time trials later today. And then we have a couple days of racing. So a lot of pressure, a lot of stress. Everybody's blood pressure is up an extra 20 points.
So it's racing day one. We just got out of driver's meeting. Things are really starting to get real. We're just getting the rigs ready, you know, putting the data systems in, getting our props on. Nerves are starting to set in.
Big day. Let's get them.
So today is Saturday. We have everything set up here in the pits. And we have a 1 hour of open practice. We're going to get Mike and Kyle on the water first, get them out there, and then I'm going to go. And then we will have time trials. It's going to be one boat at a time on the course, one hot lap as fast as you can go to determine the jetty position for heat one. After that, we're going to run heat one and two today. So after all we've done at home, all the practice, all the testing, all the getting new equipment that we could, and also all the terrible, heart-wrenching, excruciating time we had getting our boats here on time and getting by customs. It feels good to finally be here on race day and have everything ready to go. We've always had trouble, for some reason, getting our boats here and getting them out of customs and getting them here, but this year was extraordinarily tough. So it's rewarding just to have everything here and not have to go home and tell people who helped us and people who donated money, came to our fundraisers, bought t-shirts that we couldn't get from the water. So we're happy to be here. We're ready to go.
Thank you.
9:30 a.m. We're about to start pre-practice for OSY 400. We have 1 hour of open practice for 17 boats. And we're going to get Kyle and Mike out on the water and get them a couple laps first, get them in gassed up, and then I'll put my boat on the water and have a couple laps. Most of our testing at home is already done. So really just getting a feel for the course and making a few laps and getting around the buoys and getting them dressed up.
Okay, so now that we've done some practice jetty launches down there on the official starting position, staying in our own lanes, we can see what a bunch of commotion really happens down there. Several different languages at the same time, and several different boats coming and going at the same time. So there's a lot going on. We'll hit the knee on our toes.
This year, my boat's running great. You know, we haven't changed much since last year. We did the bottom, tested some props. You know, it was running great last year too. Last year I placed fifth, but any better than that this year. Last year I qualified second. I'm also hoping to qualify better than that this year.
Standing here with the race director, Aldo Cuss. He is from Estonia. He's the race director here at the World Championships. He was the man who was instrumental in getting our boats out of customs. We would not be racing if it wasn't for the efforts of this man right here. He is the race director. And how many teams are here from how many countries are represented here at this event?
30 countries at the moment.
13?
Yes, and if I'm not wrong, then it's 56 or 7 pilots.
Are you happy with that?
Yeah, I think. One biggest event in Europe, yes, with racing.
And are you happy to have all these people from all over the world coming here to Europe?
Yes, I'm very happy that you get your boats and you are here and you are racing.
And
this is the best.
Even when I don't know the problems that we have, what does it mean to the organization to have the Americans come all this way?
It makes it intercontinental.
Well, he's also a great racer and he's a great competitor. I've raced against him a lot too. Today, this weekend, he's just administrator. So hopefully we'll see him back out.
Yeah, but I have my guys on the water, so
he
watch
has,
out.
He's not in the boat himself, but he has drivers in the race.
All the drivers waited in anticipation as each and every one went out for a solitary lap around the course. Mike Akerstrom's number 8 boat was the first of the Americans. After earning second position last year, the bar was set high. However, after going for the wrong buoy, he landed in 8th place with a lap time of 65.32 seconds. Next, veteran racer Billy Allen sped around the course in 62.24 seconds. His lap was only beaten by last year's pole sitter Cezary Strumnik and 3-time world champ Rasmus Haugesma. Cezary ran a 60.54 second lap, and Rasmus claimed a 60.66 second lap. Newcomer Kyle Lewis placed 6th in 64.26 seconds. The race promised to be close and highly competitive.
So we just qualified. Not terribly pleased with how I qualified. Going into the first turn, I was actually looking at the wrong buoy. So I ended up going very wide around the first turn. But considering, I don't think I ran a bad lap.
Trials, red, white, and blue. We'll get the drivers behind.
The team headed down to the opening ceremony with a good idea of where they stood and where the competition stood.
We have here very many guests from very many countries. We have here 59 drivers. We have here drivers from the 13 countries. And we have here drivers from the two continents. That means it's a real world championship for everybody. And next I give the word to the person who is legendary in the whole powerboating. And this is Fred Hauerstein from USA. Commons Board President and Executive Committee Member, Vice President of UAE.
Thank you. This was a great pleasure to be here as a hydroplane driver myself. I was very excited to see this, and yay, Team USA.
To everybody, good luck.
When the red light expired, starting heat one, 17 finalists flew off the jetty in an explosion of spray and noise. Estonian's Harvest Magi passed Polsteter Strumnik and took command of the heat. Around the first turn, all of the competitors shuffled and shoved through the pack as far as they could. Our own American, Billy Allen, claimed the third position. The heat saw tremendous close competition. Behind Billy, the other racers vied for the higher coveted position. Hiding in his rooster tail, Anna Kasup was a close fourth, and Miroslav Buzinski from Slovakia rounded out the top five positions. Lithuania's Gintaras Marcinkus held sixth. Around the second turn, Billy Allen was close enough to breathe down the ultra-fast Strumnik's neck. Americans Lewis and Ackerstrom finished in 7th and 8th respectively.
I just ran my first heat at OSY. It was absolutely exhilarating. Ended up 6th or 7th, so not too bad for my first try.
It was a great competition. We're very happy to be here.
So, we just finished heat one of the World Championship. It was a really fun heat. I spent the whole race chasing Kyle around, getting the regular spray down. I'm ready to go up for heat two and hopefully go a little faster, maybe get around Kyle this time and have some fun. I placed 8th that heat, which is exactly where I started.
I got 3rd that heat. I had a good race with Cezary Strumnik, who was 2nd. Feeling he knew where I was the whole time, so he wasn't letting me by. I didn't quite have enough speed to get by him, but I did run a very close 3rd. The Estonian Haagis Maagi was off the dock like a shot, like we expected, so he was kind of gone with the win, and so the race was for 2nd. But we're happy with our finish. 3rd place is great.
And now we have heat 2 coming up in about an hour, and that's what we got left for the day.
So, going into heat 2, I've made some adjustments to my carburetor. Hopefully we'll be going a little bit faster. Hoping to do better than 8th, but we'll see what happens.
Heat 2 saw another fast-paced and close battle up front as the speediest boats reclaimed their high spots from the first heat. Estonian Erko Abrams made some valuable adjustments to his hull, which greatly improved his speed and handling, rocketing him all the way up from 9th to 4th. He was now in the hunt for a podium spot. Billy kept his valuable 3rd position, and Mike fought it out with Gintaras Marcinkus. Lewis and Buzinski came together in a dramatic crash out of turn 3. Lewis, now with a ruined prop, waded in the water while the other boats finished the heat. 2 Russian boats came together as well, causing a red flag. Buzinski finished 5th and Ackerstrom moved up to 6th. The heat was scored as run with no restart.
We just
just finished heat two. It was a good heat for me. We had a nice little battle with Gregor Stefaniuk from Poland and Gintaras Marcinkus from Lithuania. Kyle's boat kind of shut off after the second turn. He's still out there, so we'll see what happens. And it looked like two Russian boats came together. A lot of wood in the water.
So this is my propeller. This is not good. As you can see, all the blades are completely folded over. This was the result of a collision between myself and another boat. And the boat won.
So I'm here with Rasmus Hagasmaki, former world champion. And how many times have you won the world championship?
Three times in a row.
So what does it feel like as a European, as an Estonian, having the USA team come from America to join the Europeans at the world championships?
I always liked the US guys. All of them are really cool. And all the girls as well. And every time we race, with, especially with Billy, I can see the passion, the same passion that I have. And, it's nice to see nice people racing around.
That evening, the hospitable Estonians threw all the competitors a complimentary driver's party.
So the day's wrapped up. The team is back at the hotel. All in all, I'd say it's a good day. We have a driver that potentially has a podium spot. Mike did a killer job as always. I had a little bit of rough luck, but hey, you know, that's okay. Give it another shot tomorrow. So anyway, we're back at the hotel and we're gonna have a nice relaxing evening and good night's sleep. Peace out, America.
So we're going into day two now with two-thirds in the bank. And if we can just get a couple more good rips off the dock, I think we might have a shot at being on the podium. So we're really hoping for that.
17 boats lined up once again to compete in heat three. Since only the top three heats are scored, this heat would solidify the top standings. The Americans' best chance for a medal now rested on the shoulders of Billy Allen. Unfortunately, Kyle Lewis was reduced to the last starting spot on the jetty due to his second heat DNF. As the boats blasted out of turn one, it was the unbelievable acceleration of Hagasmaki that propelled him to the lead. Allen fought off the newfound speed of Abrams for a second, and Strumnik moved down to fourth. After two laps, Abrams settled into second, and Allen held off the speedy Strumnik to achieve his third place. Ackerstrom gained fifth, and Lewis, who started at 16th, managed to pick up an entire six spots, finishing 10th. After winning his third consecutive heat, Rasmus Hagasmaki claimed first place for the fourth year in a row, a feat unparalleled in all of UIM history.
So we just finished heat two. I got off the dock pretty quickly. Got around the first turn, actually kind of in the back, but I was okay because I got to take the buoy up the inside, and I was actually deck to deck with Cesare Strumnik for the first straightaway. But it looks like my propeller threw a blade, so hopefully we have another propeller that'll do almost as well, and I'll be back up with the four.
So I just raced heat three. I started 16th on the jetty and picked up six spots. It was a rough race. It was encouraging. The boat was handling really well, and I'm looking forward to the next heat. It's the final heat of the day. Drive the hardest I can. I have to stay focused. Remember how the boat likes to be driven, and my best. I've absolutely loved representing America over in Europe. It is a real honor.
It's just delightful to be out here and to rock the Stars and Stripes.
Okay, so we're about to run heat 4, and I've got 3/3. Fortunately, Rasmus already has 3/1, so he won. That gives Urkel the pole, and he's got a 2/4, so my only shot is to get to first if I want to get on the podium here, so it's all or nothing this time, so here we go.
With Haggis Magi sitting out the fourth heat, Abrams grabbed the pole position and sprung to the lead off the jetty. Strumnik followed in hot pursuit, and Allen battled previous world champ Brzezinski for third place. Around the first turn, things looked good for the Americans as Billy held his solid third. Behind them, Åkerström once again battled with Taras Marcinkus, followed by Kyle Lewis. Before the heat was over, Brzezinski claimed third. When the spray had settled and the points had been tallied, Haggis Magi took first, Strumnik took second, Urkel took third, Billy took fourth, Miroslav took fifth, Mike took sixth, Annika Suk took 7th, Gregor Stepaniak took 8th, and Kyle finished 9th.
So we just ran heat 4, which I needed to win to get on the podium. I got off the beach excellent, but I didn't quite have the top speed to get down to the buoy. So by the time I get to the buoy, I was third. I got around there second, and then I come out of this corner third. I got beside Strumnik going off the first lap, but he had just enough to squeeze me at the buoy. So I was right in his wake trying not to tip over, and Brzezinski got under me and put me to fourth. So I scored out with my first 3 heats, which was 3/3. Unfortunately, that wasn't enough to get me the third overall, so I'll probably end up fourth. So my shot at that heat was either winning it, or it really didn't matter where I finished. I was going to get fourth. So we ended up with fourth. We'll take that. We're happy to be here, happy to be in the race after all we went through. So the other guys did good. They had fun. They got the experience of racing over here. And we'll just go back and start working harder and try to get them again next year. So we are now breaking down and getting ready to pack up. They're about to run the last heat of 125, and we have some packing up to do and then closing ceremony. So, time for work. Let me just finish.
So I'm here with Yester Zlatchis from Latvia.
Yeah.
So how did you like the whole experience of the first world championship?
Oh, it's amazing because in Latvia we are racing like four, three, even 2 drivers, but here it's such a nice feeling to drive on such a big field of boats. You look everywhere and boats. I think this even I finished on the end like 11th. It's very comparable to my first win. I'm so happy just to be here.
Very, very happy for you. And have a safe ride home.
Yeah, thank you.
So we're at the awards giving ceremony in Tallinn, Estonia, here with my boy Wojciech.
And now we're going to the official sites of the ceremony. Everybody who arrived here in Tallinn at Lake Arku, we had 3 world championship races here at the same weekend, which is very rare for the YM. But we are starting here with 6th position in class OSI 400. Mike Åkerström, USA.
Fifth place, Italian Miroslav Pazinski. Fourth position goes to the driver from USA, Billy Allen. He's a team manager of USA. Third position goes to Erko Abrams from Estonia. Silver medal goes to the Poland, Cezary Stromnik. World champion 2016 in the category OSI 400 is won by Rasmus Haugasmäki, Estonia. Congratulations. We thank all our drivers. These are best ones in the OSI 400.
And so we just had the prize giving ceremony. Found out I had sixth, Billy had fourth. We'll be back next year, wherever the world is. We had fun this year. We'll be testing until next year. All right, so we just finished the prize giving ceremony. It feels absolutely fantastic to have represented America in this international competition of like 13, 14 countries, I don't even know. Two continents, awesome drivers everywhere. I couldn't have been happier for Bill and Mike. Mike took sixth, Bill took fourth, and that is phenomenal for the team. So I'm looking forward to working with these guys, and we'll see how they do next year.
The World Championships wrapped up, concluding good racing, great friendship, and international camaraderie.